that.
மேடம் வீடியோ மியூட் பண்ணிக்கோங்க. மேடம் வீடியோ மியூட் பண்ணிக்கோங்க. மேடம் வீடியோ ஆடியோ வீடியோ மியூட் பண்ணிக்கங்க. Priyadarshini, please stop presenting. Sir, good morning. Dharirajan sir, good morning.
இப்போ வரும் பாரு. ஹலோ, ஆ ஹலோ, வாய்ஸ் கேக்குதா பாரு. ஹலோ, ஹலோ, அதில் சரி, ரைட் ரைட், ஓகே ஓகே. அது இது பண்ண உண்டு வேற ஒன்றும் இல்லை. ஹலோ, கேக்குதா மேடம்? ஓகே மேடம், ஒரே ஒரு நிமிஷம் வந்து என்னோட பிரசன்டேஷன் வருதாங்கிறது மட்டும் செக் பண்ணிடுவோமா?
நீங்க பிரசன்ட் நவ போட்டுடுங்க சார்.
பிரசன்ட் நவ போட்றவா?
போட்றேன். கேக்குது சார்?
எஸ் சார், ரைட் மேடம், ரைட் மேடம், ரைட் மேடம், ரைட் மேடம்.
ஓகே சார்,
ஓகே. மேடம் ஒட்டே, நான் வெளில போயிட்டு திரும்ப உள்ள வரேன் மேடம்.
ஓகே சார், பேரலா லைவ் ஸ்ட்ரீமும் போயிட்டு இருக்கு சார், யூடியூப் லைவ் ஸ்ட்ரீம்.
ஆ ரைட், நான் வெளில போயிட்டு வந்துறேன் மேடம்.
ஓகே சார்,
ஓகே மேடம்,
ஓகே சார், ஓகே சார். யூடியூப் வர வீடியோ அண்ட் ஆடியோ.
ஹலோ கௌரி, குட் மார்னிங்மா. ஹலோ,
குட் மார்னிங்.
கேக்குதாம்மா?
கேக்குது மேம், கேக்குது மேம்.
ஓகே
வந்துட்டே இருக்காங்க மேம். ஷார்ப் 11:00 ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணிடலாம் மேம்.
அது நீங்க பாத்து சொல்லுங்க மேம், ஒண்ணு ப்ராப்ளம்.
ஓகே மேம், ஓகே மேம், ஓகே மேம்.
போமா இப்போ ஆன் பண்ணியாச்சு சரி 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 இப்போ நீதான் பார்க்கணும் எப்படி இருந்து என்ன பண்ணுமா இல்லை எழுதும்போது என்னன்னாக்கா எனக்கு நான் விசிபிளாக இருக்கும் போது தான் நான் எழுதுவேன் அப்போ இதை அட்ஜஸ்ட் பண்ணிப்பேன் ரைட்டா ஏன்னா எனக்கு விசிபிளாக தான் இருக்கணும் உங்களுக்கு கிளார் அடிக்குமோ ஓ அது மாதிரி ஆசை இப்போ சரியா இருக்கா இதெல்லாம் ஃபுல் ஸ்கிரீன் வச்சா ஃபுல் ஸ்கிரீன் வரும் ஒரு லைட் இருக்கு அது அடி
சார் ஒரு 2 மினிட்ஸ் சார் 11 o'clock ஷார்ப்பா ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணிடலாம் மேடம்
நோ ப்ராப்ளம் நோ ப்ராப்ளம் ஆ நோ ப்ராப்ளம் மேடம்
ஓகே
என்னலாம்
Sir, shall we start now?
Yeah, we can start.
Okay, sir. Okay. 2 minutes, sir. Just one minute,
no,
please.
No problem. After starting also, you can do those.
Okay, sir. Shall we start now, sir? Okay, sir.
Principal also waiting.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
Good morning to one and all. Homomorphisms on cyclic growth will be started now. Before that, I invite Madam Dr. S. Rajkumari, HOD Mathematics, to deliver welcome address. Rajkumari madam, please. Rajkumari madam.
Hello.
Ma'am.
Hello.
Rajkumari madam. Madam, Rajkumari madam, you are on the line. I request Rajkumari madam.
Gauri madam.
Yes sir.
But I think she left.
Yes sir,
some technical problem. Yeah, she has come.
She's on line, sir. Ma'am, Rajkumar madam, please deliver the welcome address.
Let her unmute the mic, ma'am.
Yes, Rajkumari madam.
Madam. Yes, madam. Good morning to all. Respected principal madam, present Dr. Durairajan sir, dignified participants of Tamil Nadu and various states in India, and my colleagues, Dr. R. Gauri ma'am. First of all, I shall convey my hearty felicitations to all the participants who have joined in this seminar on homomorphism on cyclic group conducted by the PG and Research Department of Mathematics, Government College for Women, Autonomous Kumbakonam. Now I am coming to the part of welcome address. Our college principal, with pleasure, has given permission to organize research topic through the webinar and also accepted to deliver her presidential address. So it's my utmost duty, and on behalf of the Department of Mathematics, I submit my hearty welcome to our college principal, madam. Next, our resource person, Dr. Durairajan sir, have obtained his IUT and PG degrees in Government Art College, Kumbakonam, in which the college is having a traditional reputation of the great genius, mathematician, legend, Srinivasa Ramanujan. Further, he completed his PhD degree in IIT Kanpur. His professional service extended from India to abroad in Ethiopia. By seeing his degrees and services in them, a field of mathematics which will reflect his eminent reader and also worked as reader in Periyar University. Needs in mathematics are manifold. So in this auspicious occasion, I put forth my everlasting memorable welcome to our resource person, Dr. Durai Rajan sir, Associate Professor of Mathematics, Bardasan University, Tiruchirappalli. Next, I extend my warm welcome to all the dignified participants of Tamil Nadu of various states in India. Colleagues, Dr. Gauri Madam, Assistant Professor of Mathematics and Organizing Secretary, who will deliver vote of thanks. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Now, I request our beloved principal, madam, to offer her presidential address. Madam, please.
Thank you, Dr. Gauri. Good morning to the most respected chief guest, Dr. Durai Rajan, sir, and dear participants. I extend a warm welcome to everyone on behalf of our college. Now, I wish to congratulate the Department of Mathematics for organizing this wonderful webinar, particularly choosing this topic on group theory. My special thanks to the organizing secretary, Dr. Gauri. Mathematicians classify mathematics as a study of patterns, and group theory is a study of symmetries. And this says enough that the place of group theory at the heart of modern mathematics. Group theory, the ultimate theory of symmetry, appears in any situation where symmetry plays a part. It plays a very important role in contemporary mathematics. It has many more applications in physics, in the field of solid state physics and elementary particles, chemistry and geology in crystallography, biology and anthropology, computer science, cryptography and cryptanalysis, and even in music, chromatic scale. It's a powerful tool that has a direct impact on research in robotics, computer vision, computer graphics, and medical image analysis. Being a computer science professor, I wish to share a few applications in a precise manner for this presidential address. To be precise, one major application is anything related to or depending on crystal structure or integrity. So this includes semiconductors, ceramics, and many similar areas. The crystals, these symmetries are described by group theory, and quantum behaviors of crystals depends very much on these symmetries. Thus, many aspects of the material science, electronic and photonics, behaviors of materials are traceable back to their group theory described features. The most directly yet invisible use in error correction used in digital networking and digital radio. The ability to detect and correct the error transmission is based on group theory. Since most people use the internet or have cell phones, the application is pretty ubiquitous, buying things online. So obviously, when you want to buy something online, you want to send your credit card details or equivalents securely. So we need to do this via encryption. The most basic forms of encryption essentially consist of a few rules applied to your message the recipient can receive, then reverse these rules to understand. Example, CISA cipher technique. While buying online, there is no reasonable way to agree a method like this beforehand. And if you have done, every single person would need their own method. So ideally, we want to be able to tell everyone how to send a secure message to, say, Amazon, like a portal, without telling them how to decode it. So it turns out this is actually possible, and often methods do it exploit the natural structure of groups. We can refer the RSA algorithm, for example. The details are not necessarily easy to understand, but group theory is no walk in the park either. The group theory is like a nail by themselves. You cannot build very much out of nails alone. And yet, if you are building anything, they are probably in there somewhere. Just so, groups are fundamental building blocks and appear everywhere. However, you usually need a little bit more than just group theory itself to make full use of it. Galileo stated that mathematics is the language which God wrote the universe. Universe cannot be read until we have learned the language and become familiar with the character in which it is written. Every human in this world must have 10 values to live in harmony with the nature and the society. They are practical value, intellectual value, social value, moral values, disciplinary values, cultural values, international values, aesthetic values, vocational values, and psychological values. So learning mathematics teaches all these values. I thank and appreciate all the most valued persons, I mean the mathematicians in this forum today, who are here to give and take all these values to some extent. Thanks for the opportunity given. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your valuable presidential address on this auspicious. Now, I request our first person, Dr. C. Durairajan, sir, Associate Professor of Mathematics, Bharathidasan University, Tiruchirappalli. He presents his lecture on homomorphisms for cyclic groups. Sir, please.
Hello.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Now my presentation is not coming. Let me. Anand is coming in the screen. Anand. Hello. No, presentation is not. Resume presentation. Right? Is it mele? Resume. Good morning to all the participants of this webinar. First of all, I would like to express my sincere thanks to the principal. She has given a very excellent introduction. Subject, the applications of the group theory, in fact, not like a mathematician. And my thanks to the Professor Gauri. She has talked to me over the phone and talked to me. Yes, no problem, because Kumbakonam means it is my native place. So I told immediately, yes, madam, no problem. The colleges, two colleges are like my colleges. I am ready to deliver the talk. So I want to thank to everyone of the organizing committee members and the organizers and the head of the department, all members from the head of the mathematics department of the government college woman. So that is sufficient. Let me start my talk. My talk is homomorphisms on cyclic groups. So now, I am going to divide this into the four part. First one is, this is group. What is group? This is my first one. Second is cyclic group, homomorphisms. And the last one is entire topics. This is the fourth one. Then we will finish it. I think I will take, they have given up to 12:30, no problem. Now already 15 minutes over, so I can take up to 12:30. After that, any query you can ask me. I am ready to that. Till then, I think everybody is muted, so it is not possible to ask the questions also, but you can ask the question in the text. Finally, the one of the persons read, I can answer all the questions, no problem. So wait till the end. So algebra means, everybody knows that group. What is group? So group means a set, a non-empty set with a binary operations. With a binary operation. This is we are calling a group. So it has to satisfy some of the conditions, right? Associative laws, identity element exist, inverse element exist. Associative laws means either you operate from left to right or right to left, the values are same. Identity elements, there is a distinguished elements in the set which satisfies the conditions. That is, there exists a distinguished element. I can call it E. E is the identity elements. A star E equal to E star A equal to A. This is true for all A in G. Right? This is the identity element axis. The associative means that has to come here. A1 star, A2 star, A3 star, etc. star, AN. Okay? Either you can go from left to right, from this side to this side, or this side to this, like this. Either you can go from here to here, or you come from here to here, the values are same. That is, either operate left to right or right to left, the answer will be same. That is why normally we are writing A star B star C equal to A star B star C. This is we are normally writing. This means first we are operating A, B, then C. That is, we are coming from left to right. Here the right side is, we are starting B star C, that is C B, then this side, right? That is either left to right or right to left, the values are same. The identity element is distinguished elements, I told you. Then inverse, the third one is inverse element exists. That means for every A in G, there exists element B in G such that A star B equal to B star A equal to the identity element, what I told, the distinguished elements. So, if these three conditions are satisfied, we are calling the group. Of course, normally the book, they have written the first property is nothing but the binary operations, right? Binary operations, you take any two elements, operate in this one, the resulting elements belongs to G. So, normally, once I say it is a binary operation, I never used to say the closed property. If I say the operation, then I can say the 1, 2, 3, 4 conditions, right? Previously, I told G is a non-empty set, star is the binary operations. Therefore, this is a group, right? So, natural, the law, many more examples. The standard example is Z, Q, R, C. These all are group with respect to multiple additions, right? These all are, the operation is under addition plus, these all are group. Of course, with respect to multiplication, these all are not the groups. Z, set of all integer, rational numbers, real numbers, the collection of complex numbers, right? These all are group with respect to addition, not multiplications. But some of the groups are there. Let me give one example. This is standard notation. We used to say that general linear group over F. This is collection of N by N invertible matrix. Matrices over F. F is, I am taking a field. This also a form a group under matrix multiplications. Under the matrix multiplication. This is my first example. This is my second example. These two examples, there is some differences there. These all are not the same. Here, this is normal. The first example is with respect to usual addition. The second example with respect to usual matrix multiplications. That's all. But if you take the first example, you take two elements from any one of said x and y. X plus y is same as y plus x. But if you take the second example, you cannot say that the matrix A into B, B, C. You cannot say always this is true. Most of the time it is not true. So if satisfy this condition, any group, then we are saying it is a abelian group. Abelian group. But the example 2 is not the abelian group. This never, I can give the existence. There is a two elements from the general linear group. It will not satisfy the commutative property. Therefore, the group is not a abelian group. The example 1's, all groups are abelian group. The example 2 is not a abelian. This is the abelian. No, I don't want to take much time on this one. So these are, everybody knows that. Next one is the subgroup of the group. Subgroup means it must be a subset. Subset of the group G. And also this, the H must be group with respect to the operation. What we have taken for the G. This is also a group. Then we are saying H is a subgroup of G. We are saying that this is subgroup of G. First must be, it must be a subset. Then it must be a group with respect to the same operations, what we have taken for G. So a simple example is, let me take that Z. N times Z, the multiple of N, the collection of integer N, M, such that M belongs to Z. This is a subgroup of Z. This is with respect to addition, this is a group. N is itself is a group. Therefore, we are saying it is a subgroup of this. Similarly, I can take many groups. So another one example for the subgroup is, let me take G is a group. Here, whatever I am taking, the generally I am writing G group means it is a group with respect to the multiplications and the operation star I am taking here, right? So let me take one element A from G. So this, the collection of A power N, N belongs to Z, is a subgroup. Subgroup of G. If you take two elements from H, AN and AM, so AN star AM, here let me tell to you one thing. A power N means A star, etc. star A. This is, I have taken N times. This is N times. If you take Z, let me take one element from Z, M. M power N means we are writing M plus M plus M plus N times. That's all, right? So here the operation is, I have taken star. So I am writing A star, N times. So A power N means, this A power N means it is a meaning of we are writing A which is the operation, what the operation we have given for G, right? Therefore, this is the A power N means this one, right? If I take two elements X, Y in H, one X is A power R, another is Y is A power S. So A power R star A power S equal to, here we are taking R time, another is S time, the all together A power R plus S. That is, let me take X equal to A power R, Y equal to A power S, X star Y equal to A power R star A power S. This we are taking S times, this we are writing S times, the total I can get, A power R plus S. So the R plus S is the, R is integer, S is integer, therefore this also belongs to H. Similarly, if I take the identity elements, A power 0 is the identity elements. A power N inverse is A power minus N. So everything is there, it is a group. It is a group. In fact, it is a abelian group. You can write A power X, Y equal to, I write in between star. This is A power R star A power S equal to A power R S. The integer is satisfying the commutative property. I can write this one. This is A power S star A power R. That is Y star X. Therefore, this is a commutative, it satisfies the commutative property. Therefore, this H is a abelian group. So this H is abelian group. In fact, if you see that, if you take any elements in H, it is of the form A power something. That means the H is generated by A. We are saying that. That means if you take any elements in H, it can be written as A power something. Then that group is, we are saying that the group generated by that elements. That means G is, this H is generated by A. Generated by A. Here is by. Generated by A. Such a subgroup is, we are calling that cyclic subgroup generated by A. So This is, we are calling the cyclic groups generated by A. If whole group is generated by some elements, we are calling it is a cyclic group. That means, if you take, if I take G is generated by this one. That means I am writing every element in X is A power something of the form. That means G is generated by A for some A in G. Then we are calling that G is a cyclic group. We are calling this is a cyclic group. That means if G is cyclic group, means it must be generated by some elements. That's all. G is cyclic group means it must be generated by some elements. Okay. Before coming to cyclic group, let me come to some basic things. One is order of G. Order of G is the number of elements in G, the cardinality of G. This is one. The second one is order of an element in G. I can write the element is A, I can write. That means the least positive integer n such that a power n equal to identity elements. That means a power 0 is identity elements, a power 1 is not identity, a power 2 is not identity, etc. a power n minus 1 is not equal to identity. The first elements whose power is identity is a power n equal to is identity. The n is the first integer such that a power n equal to I. That's why we are writing the least positive integer n such that a power n equal to I. So the order of a is we are calling that n. For example, let me take the real number plus. Real number plus. I don't want to take this example. This one, let me write here star. That means R is, or otherwise I can write R removing zero. This is group with respect to multiplications. Now let me take here minus one is there. The identity element of multiplicative identity is 1 here. Minus 1 power 1 is not equal to 1, but minus 1 square is 1. So this implies order of minus 1 is 2. So this is this one, because least integer is n, least power is 2, satisfying the conditions. Therefore, we are saying that the order of this is 2. This is the things, right? Another thing is I would like to say is, if I take one elements, another one result is, I can write, if a power n equal to identity, if and only if order of a divides m. This is the standard result. This is for, here a is any elements in G, right? Here I have taken this is for any A in G. This one is A power N equal to identity if and only if order of A divides N. This is the standard result. I don't want to go there. So let me take the set of all complex number removing zeros is group with respect to multiplications. Here minus 1 is there, minus I is there, or I also there. The order of minus 1 is 2, right? There what we have seen the earlier, the same thing. Minus 1 power any even number 2 times m is identity. This means the order of this is order of minus 1 divides 2m. It is an even number, it will divide this one. Similarly, if you take I, order of I is 4. So order of I is 4, I power 4 equal to identity, I power 8 equal to identity, I power 12 equal to any power of, any multiple of 4 equal to identity. So that's what this result, this one. That's what this result, okay? This I am going to use this one. These are all things I will use. So next one is, let me come to the cyclic group. Yes, the only thing is that one. Yeah, now cyclic group. I already have told you what is related by a single elements, right? Okay, then we are calling this A is generator of T. The question is there any other generator? The question is there any other generator? Right? So, I mean that if G has only one generator or more generator, that is the question here. G has one generator or more generators. So let me come to the every group is two type. One is finite group, another is infinite group. Similarly, one is a finite cyclic group, another is infinite cyclic group. Let me come to the what is infinite cyclic group? It is in the cardinality is infinite. Okay, now let me take in this one, the first one, cyclic group. Infinite cyclic group. This is, let me take, this is generated by A. My question is there any other generator, right? Before that, let me come to the, if G is a cyclic group generated by A, so every elements in G can be written as A power something. So the elements of G are, I told you this one, N belongs to Z. Even it is, here let me write, this means, this is A power N such that N belongs to Z. If the cardinality is infinite, so A power 0, A power 1, A power 2, etc. This side, the left side, A power minus 1, A power minus 2, etc. infinity. So there are infinite number of elements, infinite. The only thing is, if G is infinite, is there any two elements are distinct? That means two different integer in Z, two integer, different integer, A power, and the power of A gives different values. That's all. I can take here, this one, let me come to here. Where is it? The thing is, I am finding the my mouse. This one is, etc. A power minus 2, A power minus 1, identity, A square, etc. This one. This is this one. Now, I have taken G is the infinite cyclic group, belongs to Z. So, this is this one. My question, two elements in this one, where let me take two different elements in this set, right? That means I can take I and A power G. Another thing is I told two different elements means I not equal to J I have taken. Either it is positive or negative.